Hello friends, welcome to Dipta's Pathshala. Today we will continue the chapter electric current and its effect. In our previous session, we have already discussed about electric circuit and heating effects of electricity. So in this session, we will particularly focus on safety devices. So safety devices are used to overcome the problem of short circuits and overload. So what is a short circuit? Short circuit means when the electricity travels in an unintended path, means the path in which it should not travel. A short circuit is an abnormal connection between two nodes of an electric circuit intended to be at different voltage. So here in this picture, you can see how two wires are joined together, so which leads a short circuit. Okay, so short circuits can occur when electrical circuit wires are exposed or damaged. It means when the insulating, the coating, okay, in above the wires, it will damage or it will come off for any reason, and by mistakenly they will come in contact, it will lead to short circuit. A loose connection on one of the two wires in a junction box or outlet box may cause a short circuit, and it may cause damage to the device and possibly the fire. Okay, so in both the pictures you can see how short circuits is occurring. So now what is overload? So all electrical circuits are designed to handle a limited amount of electricity. When you draw more electricity than what a circuit can handle, a circuit overload will occur. Here in the picture you can see how so many appliances are attached to a single socket, so it will lead to the overload. So it may damage to the appliances and it may cause massive fire. That's why there should be circuit breakers. Circuit breaker trips help in breaking the circuit and thus the current flow. If there are no breakers, the overload would cause the circuit wiring to overheat. This could either melt the wire insulation or even lead to the massive fire. So to overcome these problems, we use safety devices like fuse and MCB, means miniature circuit breaker. Now let's talk about fuse. So a fuse is a household safety device, as I already told you, which is based on the principle of heating effects of electricity. A fuse consists of a wire that breaks when high electricity is passed. Okay, here in the picture you can see two different types of fuses. This can break the circuit and prevent the current from entering device and causing damage to the device and possibly the fire. So let's discuss this one by one. So here you can see this is the cartridge fuse. Here this is the fuse wire, and the fuse wire, they are made from either from copper, zinc, or you can say we can make it from alloy of tin and lead. Mostly it is prepared from the alloy of tin and lead, okay, which is having the low melting point and high resistance. Understood? So when you can see here, it is here the fuse is attached, okay, and when there will be a short circuit, what will happen? This fuse wire will break. Here you can see now the fuse wire has broken. So here you can see it will become a open circuit. As the fuse wire will break, it will stop the flow of electricity so that there will be no harm to the appliances. Now you understood. Now let's discuss about the plug fuse. Here in this picture you can see this kind of fuse is called as the plug fuse, and this part, it has two parts. This part is called as the casing, or you can say the socket, and here this is the grip. This is made from porcelain. This is the grip. Okay, here you can see in the grip what is there. In both end there are two rectangular shaped metallic plates which is made from copper, and here you can see this is the fuse wire. So when there will be any short circuit, okay, so this wire will break. Here you can see, and there will be a gap, so there will be a open circuit and it will stop the flow of electricity. That's why the appliances will not be damaged. Understood? Now as the fuse will break, then we need to replace it by putting another new fuse in that previous place. Understood? That's why we have to change it manually. So to overcome this problem, nowadays we are using the MCBs, that is the miniature circuit breaker. These are also safety devices like fuse. So the MCB too breaks the circuit. But how it breaks the circuit? By switching off. It will go off automatically by the overload in the circuit. So when there will be any short circuit, the switch will come automatically off position. So what will happen? The circuit will break. There will be open circuit. So it will stop the flow of electricity. So there will be no damage to the appliances. So after that, when the flow will be normal, that time you can manually switch it on, or in some devices there is automatic system, it will go automatically switch on. Understood? That's why we can avoid the short circuit and overload problems. Understood? So this is all about our today's session. Let's have a quick revision. So we learned that short circuits occur when electrical circuit wires are exposed or damaged and there is a direct contact between the wires. Connection of many devices to a single circuit may lead to overload. Wires made from some special materials melt quickly and break when large electric currents are passed through them. These materials are used for making electric fuses, which prevent fire and damage to the electrical appliances. So hope you enjoyed the video. If you are having any doubt, please write it in the comment section, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.